In this video, I'm going to talk about how you as an industrial customer shortlist a solar developer who can serve you with the open access solar solution. Hi, my name is Gaurav Kavatra. I'm director at Infinia Solar. In my recent conversation with the CFO of an automotive company based out of Uttar Pradesh, having a turnover of around 1200 crore, the CFO asked me, Gaurav, I have 8 to 10 proposals on my table from the companies who are ready to serve me with the open access solar solution. But I'm confused. How do I shortlist the right developer for my company who can serve me with the open access solar solution? So I decided to make a video on this topic so that it helps all of you to think from a framework perspective. So my advice or to the industrial and commercial customers is to use what I call as RRR framework. There are three R's in this. So first R is results. So look at the solar developer results, specific results. For example, someone who has delivered the project already in that state under the open access model, talk to their customers. Second, someone who has delivered the open access project anywhere in India and in a state which is similar to your state. So this is the first R, which is, you should evaluate developer upon. Second R is look at what I call as a relevance, right? So look at from the relevance perspective is to look at the developer which is relevant for your organization. So for example, you can look at whether they understand the specific terms that you need, whether they understand the specific interest that you have. You may have a challenge of, let's say, having a shorter tenure, let's say 10-year tenure, vis-a-vis a longer tenure, then a 25-year tenure, and you're ready to pay a higher tariff for that. Then look at a developer who can serve a 10-year contract, vis-a-vis a 25-year contract. Second thing in the relevance is look at the developer who has served in the same industry. For example, let's say if it is auto industry, so someone who has served in the same auto industry, so that because there are higher chances if you are in the same industry and if they have served your competitive suppliers, then probably they understand your need desire problems well. So this is on the relevance part of it. Third R that you should look at what I call as a resonance. So resonance means someone which resonate with your thought process, someone with which you as an organization resonate with. For example, some of the companies prefer, a developer who are international, who are foreign based and have good funding in place so that they can deliver you project on time. Some industrial users prefer working with Indian companies who are owned by the people in the same state, for example, people in Gujarat or Uttar Pradesh. So that's the third thing that you should evaluate, which is resonance. So let me quickly review all three R's. The first R is result. Look at who can deliver you on time, who has delivered in the past. Second R is to look at the relevance. Someone who understand your needs, who understand your terms. Third is the resonance. Someone, the developer, whether it is owned by the, whether it is a foreign developer or it's an Indian developer or the developer is within your state. Hope you found value in this video. And if you want to build and have a further conversation on this topic, then comment in the comment box below and I and my team will reach out to you. Thank you. I will see you in my next video.